Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. While I've got your attention, I'd like to ask that if you like what I'm doing, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I would appreciate your support via my PayPal tip jar, my Subscribestar, my merch stores on Teespring, or a place on my website where you can support me further, and there are links to all of these in my description box. I've become increasingly annoyed with people who call for the impeachment of congresspersons. Now, typically, calls for impeachment are in response to some stupid communist idea put forth by this mental midget, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, or Red Cortez, as I call her on this show, because it fits. Unfortunately, much as you might want to be rid of her, and I do, you can't impeach a congressperson. Unfortunately, people calling for impeachment, this means that they've never read the Constitution. If they did, they'd know that you can't impeach congresspersons. You can only impeach presidents and judges, but not senators or congressmen. So please read the Constitution. Become particularly familiar with the 1st, 2nd, 4th, and 10th Amendments, because these are the ones that are violated every waking moment by your president, congresspersons, senators, and judges. And I have a link to the U.S. Constitution online. It's scrolling past in my lower third, and it's in my description box. If these people weren't violating these various amendments and the Constitution itself with every breath they take, the federal government would be a fraction of its current size, and all of our political and social ills would evaporate overnight. From the cost of medical care, to the cost of tuition, to the quality of you and your children's education, these are all problems caused by a federal government that long ago overstepped the bounds of the Constitution. Because if you don't know that congresspersons can't be impeached, then you have been missing out on a very basic level of education. You're now going to have to make up for the deficits by actively educating yourself. Fortunately, if you can read, something I know from experience as an IT instructor at the police that shall not be named, they don't teach anymore in K-12, but if you can read, you can self-educate. DuckDuckGo.com, DuckDuckGo.com, not Google because they suck, is waiting for you with open arms. Just search for anything you want to know. So senators and congresspersons can't be impeached. They can be expelled, which is a completely different process from impeachment. Now, here is all that the Constitution has to say about expelling a member of the House or the Senate in Article 1, Section 5. Quote, each House may determine the rules of its proceedings, punish its members for disorderly behavior, and, with the concurrence of 2/3, expel a member, end quote. So in essence, what that's saying is if you want to expel a member of Congress, you have to have 2/3 of the House of Representatives actually vote to do it. Now that sounds relatively simple, but it's actually almost impossible. While the Constitution does specify this 2/3 majority vote, both the House and the Senate are free to decide how such a vote comes to the floor. So both houses have established specific procedures in order to get to that 2/3 majority vote. And try to hang on to this for a little bit because it gets a little complicated. In the House of Representatives, which is where Red Cortez sits, a member must be referred to the Committee on Standards of Official Conduct, which is informally, you usually hear about this as the House Ethics Committee. And in the Senate, the member is referred to the Select Committee on Ethics, which again is usually called the Senate Ethics Committee. The committee may then ask other representatives or senators to come forward with complaints about the member who is under consideration, or they may initiate an investigation into the member's actions. Now, sometimes members may refer a resolution for an investigation for this member or the matter that needs to be recommended. They may recommend either expulsion or censure, which is another form of disciplinary action. I'll talk about that in a little bit. So Rule 11 of the Rules of the House of Representatives states that the House Ethics Committee can investigate allegations that a member has violated, quote, any law, rule, regulation, or other standard of conduct applicable to the conduct of such member in the performance of his duties or the discharge of his responsibilities, end quote. And the Senate Ethics Committee has very similar. The committee, the House Ethics Committee in this case, may then report back with their findings to the chamber, that is the whole House of Representatives, as to its findings and recommendations for further action. However, to get there, when an investigation is launched by either committee, the investigatory subcommittee, they take a part of this committee and break it off into a subcommittee, And once this subcommittee has called evidence, talked to witnesses, and held an adjunctory hearing, it will then rule on whether the member is found to have by the committee to have committed the actions, and then vote on a recommendation. So if expulsion is then recommended, then the subcommittee's report will be referred to the full House, where the members may then vote to accept, reject, or alter the report's recommendations. And then, if you're going to bring up a vote to expel, it requires two-thirds of the Congress to agree to do it. Now, if this sounds like the House and Senate have structured things so that it's damn near impossible to expel a member, well, congratulations, you go to the head of the class. In the entire history of the United States, there have been only 20 members of the House or the Senate that haven't been expelled. 15 were from the Senate and 5 were from the House of Representatives. And of those, one member's expulsion, William K. Sebastian of Arkansas, was posthumously reversed. What good did doing him after death? I don't know. The great majority of the people who were expelled, 17 members, were removed from office for their support of the Confederacy when they seceded, and then that led to the Civil War. There have only been 3 other expulsions. In 1797, Senator William Blount of Tennessee was expelled for treason. The charges were centered on he was trying to incite the Creek and Cherokee Indian tribes to aid the British in conquering the then Spanish-held territory of West Florida. Then in 1980, 200 years later, Representative Michael Myers of Pennsylvania was expelled for accepting bribes. And then in 2002, most recently, Representative Jim Traficant of Ohio was expelled after he was convicted on numerous counts of bribery, racketeering, and tax evasion. That is only really 3 expulsions in over 220 years that weren't due to sympathies involved in the Civil War. 3 expulsions in over 220 years. That is about how likely it is that Red Cortez is going to be expelled from Congress. Now, there is another form of discipline called censure, and that's been used quite a lot. Members of Congress who have been censured are then required to give up any committee seats that they hold. Censured members doesn't remove them from office, and so they keep their title, stature, power, and the ability to vote. There are sometimes legislative consequences that come with a reprimand or a censure, but it is really, censure is just a slap on the wrist. So you can't impeach a congressperson nor a senator. The best you can do is expulsion, and the rules regarding that make it intentionally difficult to expel someone. You really have to be outright traitor or involved in accepting bribes or something, you know, a real crime in order to be expelled. Now, Red Cortez has not and probably never will rise to the level of expulsion. That's just improbable. She probably won't ever even be referred to the House Ethics Committee for an investigation. Red Cortez will probably never be censured. I mean, you can feel free to call your congressperson and ask, but it's extremely unlikely. And in any case, she'd only lose her seat on some committees, but she'd probably no doubt get them back after the public's forgotten about it. That is what usually happens. Censure really is just a slap on the wrist and basically meaningless in the long term. The fact of the matter is that we are stuck with Red Cortez for the next 20 to 40 years. She will be in Congress until she decides to leave, and not one plank second before. Red Cortez's district is the sections in green of this New York City. The district includes the eastern part of the Bronx and part of North Central Queens. As with most metro areas, New York City is filled to overflowing with communists and socialists. They approve of Red Cortez. It's just that simple. The people in the eastern part of the Bronx and part of North Central Queens want communism and socialism in the U.S. The last Republican to hold that seat was Susan Molinari, who served from 1990 to 1993, only one term. At the time, this wasn't even the 14th district. It didn't exist due to various redistricting over the years, which happens all the time. Red Cortez won largely because she figured out how to win the primary against an incumbent Democrat, Congressman Joe Crowley. Now, note that Crowley was a much more centrist Democrat. Red Cortez's constituents voted for a communist over a centrist. Now, New York 14 will absolutely never vote for a Republican, nor an independent, nor a third-party candidate. As Nancy Pelosi herself has said, New York 14 will vote for a glass of water as long as it has a D taped to the side. The reality is that Red Cortez's voters want her in office. Ultimately, Red Cortez is going to become another Nancy Pelosi, a withered, aged, old crone who can barely keep her mental faculties together long enough to give a speech. Red Cortez will not be impeached. No congressman can be. Red Cortez will not be expelled. She has to have done something really criminal for that. She will not be censured. And even if she was, so what? It's just a slap on the wrist. Red Cortez will not be voted out of office. Her constituents are communists and socialists who want her there. Red Cortez will be in Congress exactly as long as she wants to be. She is here for the rest of my life and probably the rest of my children's lives. If we're lucky, she won't run for president someday. Actually, I'm betting that she will. Red Cortez is simply here to stay, and there is nothing that anyone can say or do that will change that fact. And that is all that I have to say about that. I'd love to keep the conversation going, so please leave your comments, questions, and nasty remarks, and I'll do my best to respond to you. So, thanks for watching. That's all the time that we have today for this episode of the highly acclaimed, world-renowned Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And I'm Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.